need to tell you something.
It's Charlotte here, and today's video is going to be a DIY Tumblr inspired room decor video. So in today's video, I will be showing you how to make three really cute room decor items that can Tumblrize your room and just brighten it up for spring and summer. So I'll show you how to make a canvas, some pillows behind me, those two pillows, and a oil diffuser that will make your room smell amazing. All these DIYs are really inexpensive, and you can find all the supplies at your local $2 shop, dollar store, craft supply store, pretty much anywhere. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you haven't already subscribed, just click that subscribe button down below and subscribe. Give this video a big thumbs up. Let's try and get this video to 300 likes, and let's just get on to the DIYs. Yeah.
If you could take my pulse right now, it would feel just like a sledgehammer.
So what you need to create this geometric canvas is some paint, tape, scissors, glitter, a paintbrush and a canvas, and also some glue. I used Mod Podge. To begin this DIY, start by using your tape and putting it all over your canvas, creating different diagonal lines and different shapes. I mainly try to stick with triangles and just put it over the edges. And this bit is just go crazy with this. Put as many as you want, just create it like you're making abstract. And yeah, it doesn't have to be perfect at all, so just put that all over the canvas, as you can see what I'm doing right here. Making sure to smoothen out any bubbles so no paint will get under the tape. And then it is time to begin painting. I had 16 different shapes on my canvas, and I had 5 colours including the glitter. So each one of my colours got 3 different shapes and my glitter got 4, so that worked out perfectly. So just paint them on, making sure you have all the different colors spaced out. So I just use light pink, kind of a hot pink, a light purple and a light blue, and then of course I just added my gold glitter, which I absolutely love. To try and prevent bleeding when painting around the tape, try and make downward strokes and not strokes towards the tape, so none of the paint will be able to get under the tape and hopefully it will not bleed. But if it does, that's no big deal. And now it is time for my favourite part, which is the glitter. So I just took Mod Podge because I thought it was a really good glue, and I just coated it all over the spot where I wanted to put the glitter, making sure that I had let all the other paint dry so there's no possible way of any of the glitter sticking to the paint. So I just dumped all of my glitter all onto that space, and then I just used my finger to spread out the parts where there was lots and lots of glitter, and just make sure you get that all on the edges, because I know I forgot to put in some of the edges and I went back, because it is really hard to notice where there is not glitter because there is just glitter everywhere. So make sure you push that to all the edges and all the outside. I would recommend when doing this glitter to either put paper down on your surface or do it outside, because you'll get glitter everywhere if you don't. So I just tipped all the glitter off, just pretty much just hit the canvas and the glitter should pour right off. This is probably the best part of the DIY, because you get to see your work come together and it is so fun. So just start peeling your tape off. It is that easy, just peel it off. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Just peel all the tape off. I'm really happy with the way this one turned out. It has brightened up my room so much, and it is so easy, and you can do this with any colors that match your room. So just have fun doing this. It is so pretty and I absolutely love it. What you need for this geometric pillow is a paintbrush, some paint, tape, and a pillowcase. So first, using your tape, tape the border of the pillowcase so you don't get any tape on the outside. So pretty much just tape a border, making sure there is no bubbles in it so the paint won't be able to bleed, and just stick that all the way around the border of the pillow. Then create another border on the outside of that tape, just sticking it to the table so no paint will be able to seep through. Using the same method as the canvas, just stick your tape all over the pillowcase, creating lots of diagonal lines and shapes and making sure there is no bubbles in the tape. Then start to paint. I use acrylic paint, so it's probably not washable, so try not to get the pillowcase dirty. You probably could use fabric paint if you wanted, but I just decided to use acrylic paint. And the pillowcase will soak up the paint pretty quickly, so just make sure you use a lot of paint and just dab it on. Inside of the pillowcase, I put in a large square of cardboard just so none of the paint will go through onto the other side of the pillowcase, so you could do that if you wanted to. And because you can't really put glitter onto a pillowcase, I used metallic gold paint. Of course, you can use any colors you want to match your room. I just went with these colors because it matched my canvas and I thought it would just look really pretty with the two of them together. Again, the same as the canvas, when painting around the edges near the tape, just paint in the opposite direction from the tape, trying not to go towards the tape. Probably because it's a pillowcase, it'll be easier for the paint to seep under the tape. So when pulling off the tape, just go slow and just pull it off, same as the canvas, but go a bit slower because it is a pillowcase, and making sure that the paint is dry before doing this. And then put in your pillow and then you are done. This DIY cost me under $10. The pillow insert was $4 and so was the cover. And then I had the paint and the tape and it was so easy and I absolutely love the way it turned out. It brightens up my bed so much. And I think this would make a great addition and brighten up anybody's bed. And now for the last DIY, which is the scented oil diffuser. You will need some washi tape, skewers, a jar, baby oil, and some essential or fragrant oil. So begin by cutting little strips of washi tape. I just went for bright colors so I would match my other two DIYs, and then tape them onto the end of your skewers. They can be any skewers, but I use bamboo skewers. Just any kebab skewers really would work. And then tape them on and fold them over and then create any design you want to, just making them little flags, absolutely anything. Then fill your glass or jar with baby oil to as far as you would like. And then pour in your essential oil or fragrant oil. I poured the whole jar in because I wanted mine to smell a lot. And then put in your skewers with your cute washi tape flags on the end and mix it all up. And there you have your scented oil diffuser, which will make your room smell really, really nice. And it was that easy and simple, and it was really cheap to make as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video on the Tumblr room decor. Hopefully it gives you some inspiration to brighten up your room for spring and summer. If you do recreate any of these, send me your recreations. My Twitter is MichelleBeauty1 and my Instagram is MichelleBeauty1. I will link them both down below. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you haven't already subscribed, click that subscribe button. Give this video a big thumbs up. And I will see you in the next video. I love you all so much. Bye.